Hey, gang. Hello, hello, hello. Am I on? Yes, I'm on. Hi, hello, it's me. It's me, the big V. It's your girl, Vic Girl here. Having a little technical difficulties. I was supposed to start at 6, but I had a little trouble with a computer and an update, so I started 7. Hi, Cow Dizzle. Hello, hello, hello. It's good to see you. Good to see you. Glad to see you. See you. About this game, L.A. Noire. I remember when this game came out, a friend of mine played it. I didn't pick it up because I was a little daunted by it because it was very high definition. I didn't have a flat screen TV, and she did, and the game was so clear and so beautiful, and I loved it, but I never picked it up. And as the years went by, I still never picked it up. Then my PS3 died, and there went my gaming. Also, my gaming died when that happened. But I was so glad to hear this was coming out for the PS4, and I just had to play it. So this is going to be interesting. Back in Los Angeles, 1947, yes, the Sam Spades, the Dashiell Hammetts. And a lot of you have no idea what I'm talking about. Think Maltese Falcon, Humphrey Bogart. Then you'll be in the right area. So I think, without further ado or me running off of the mouth anymore, we are going to get into L.A. Noire. Dun, dun, dun. Or if it's too loud. It's kind of loud in my headphones. Oh, man. Probably should have done this before, but I had some technical things to iron out. So good. Oh, that's awesome. Oh, wow. I'm already loving it. I'm already loving it. And I haven't even gotten to the game yet. That's crazy.
A city on the verge of greatness. A new type of city based not on the man, but on the automobile. The car, the symbol of freedom and vitality. Where every man can own his own home and have room to breathe and not be overlooked by his neighbors. The city where a man's home is his castle. A quarter acre of the dream made possible by victory. The city of opportunists. The city of dreams, where Hollywood will shape the thoughts and desires of the entire planet. The city of pioneers. A city of dreamers.
Especially if you have, if you like film, noir films.
A city of undercurrents.
Films of the 40s.
Where not everything is as it seems.
Dark, gritty crime dramas.
A 20th century city that will become a model for the world. City that has no boundaries, that will stretch as far as the eye can see.
You gotta love it. You gotta love it. Oh my god. This is so awesome already. It's like, ah! It's like that episode of
Archie. In the Marine Corps, you deal with the chain of command. Mistakes get made, but you deal with them. You know what you're fighting for and that you're on the same team. But dealing with corruption is like chasing shadows. You never know whether the guy you're talking to is on the pad, or whether it's your partner, or maybe even the watch commander. So who do you trust, Cole? I made up my mind a long time ago.
KGBL calling car, 14 Adam. 14 Adam, come in.
Go ahead, KGPL.
14 Adam, see the detective at ambulance shooting at 6th and Industrial Street. Unit 16 William requests uniform assistance for an evidence search. 14 Adam, code 2.
Roger, 14 Adam en route.
Okay, now why is gameplay... Hold on, why is it doing... Why is it even doing that? Okay, not current. Okay. Yellow icon.
Here we go again. They don't request uniforms for an evidence search unless there's some kind of catch.
Ever the optimist.
From the beam of sunshine himself.
Floyd Rose, homicide. You my backup?
Yes, sir. Phelps and Dunn, Wilshire Division.
We had a shooting took place down this alleyway. We have the Vic, Scooter Payton, a Negro male bagged up and on his way to Central Morgue. Witness says a tall white guy, our shooter, put two in the Vic's head and then threw his piece. I need you guys to try and recover the gat.
You want us to look anywhere in particular?
Give it your best shot, guys. The dead guy's a lowlife. I'm not expecting any miracles here.
And if we recover the weapon?
Bag it and return it to technical services.
You hurried up, Floyd.
I'm out of here.
To be.
Happy hunting.
Yeah, so we the beat cops, got to do the grunt work for the detectives. And I like
this
to
is
know
a fist pump. Just
my
going through the motions.
Is doing
probably
this.
Right.
Hold on. I want to get this out of the way. I don't know why it seems to be automatically recorded.
Let's just get it over and done.
All right, have it your way. We'll search right up to the back wall. If you still don't come up with anything, come find me and we'll talk it out. Two heads are always better than one.
We're cluing for looks.
What do you think?
Have a good look around. It could be anywhere.
Okay, something is vibrating.
Look at this junk.
Something's vibrating. What does that mean? Okay. L.
It's not my job to pick through other people's trash.
Okay.
Nothing significant.
Looking at it. It's an empty bottle.
What have you got, Phelps? Anything?
Okay, how do I put it down?
Jesus. Cole, come take a look at this.
Okay, there we go.
I tell you, I'm jinxed. I always get landed with this crap.
Oh, I see. That's how you do it. Okay.
We're never gonna find it. It's a waste of time.
Mind is the final frontier. I thought space was the final frontier.
Dr. Fontaine, could I have a word?
Of course, young man.
I really enjoyed your lecture, doctor.
Okay, this
psychiatry
is
seems
to
have a tremendous
later,
amount to offer.
Why, thank you. I'm always happy to receive acknowledgement for my work. The mind is the last great mystery in medicine.
Mind is a
terrible. Are you thinking of specializing, Mr.
Sheldon? Courtney Sheldon. I'm only in second year, doctor. They fast-tracked me a year because of my experience during the war.
Ah.
That's what I wanted to talk to you about. battle fatigue and collapse under duress. Can it be helped?
I would say yes, given the right set of circumstances.
Well, of course.
Trauma forces the mind to close down, retreat in on itself. We try to find ways to unlock the mind again through a combination of therapy and drug treatment. Mm. Hypnosis and therapy are powerful tools in the right hands, Sheldon.
I've been to visit some of the guys at the VA hospital. A good friend of mine, he's so far away. It's like he's wandering
around. You went through a lot together.
Yes, Doctor.
Give me his details and I'll make a prognosis. I have a number of clinics in Los Angeles, Courtney Sheldon. And your penance for your friend's help is to come and work at one of them in your spare time, with what little spare time a medical student has. Uh-huh. Is that a deal?
Is it ever? I can't thank you enough.
I'm not promising a cure, Courtney. Mm-hmm. I want you to remember that. Every physician has patients that he cannot hope to cure, for whom he can only smooth the path to death.
Uh-huh. I'm already not liking him. He's smarmy. He's smarmy as all get out. With that smooth talking southern accent, just, yeah. Why is my machine doing that? Okay, let's put that down. Let's get out of here. And we're still looking for clues. I, the lowly beat cop, doing the grunt work for the detectives who will take all the glory. But one day, I will be a detective. Ha 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 ha. So I guess when you get... okay. So I guess when you get near something...
Now.
Is that a paintbrush? I guess when you get near something, your controller vibrates. Looks like a paintbrush. Or a flattened cigar, or a cigar? With a tip on it? Oh, there's a big clue right there. There's a big clue. That's not good.
Shooter put him up against the wall and blew his brains out.
Hell of a way to go.
Doesn't really matter how you go once you're gone.
Don't get all deep on me, Phelps.
Swipe up and down. Clues. Bloodstain. Okay. My little detective notebook there, my out like that. Okay. Are we looking down the hall? Of course we are. We're looking for clues. Oh. I see the shadow of a gun.
Ralph, there's something on the rooftop.
I see.
How the hell did you see that?
Reflection in the window. Looks like it might be our weapon. I'm gonna see if I can find a way up there.
All right. Don't hurt yourself.
Cow Dizzle, I'm already tingling. But maybe it's me because I've always been into noir films and all that, and it's kind of a cool experience to be playing. It's like you're playing one. It's like you're actually in one.
The gun's up on the roof, right? So we need to find a way up.
I got to find a way to the roof. Probably have to climb on these dumpsters. Oh, okay.
What kind of chumps do these homicide guys think we are?
The kind of dude, you know. Wait, what is that? What's that there? Aha.
Doesn't appear to be connected.
Okay, well, you never know.
Doesn't tell me anything.
Okay. Building looks vacant.
Just checking.
I don't want to wait around all night for the super to let us in. Is there a way up from the outside? How you doing, Cole? Found it yet?
Yep, I got it.
I don't even want to think about what that smell is.
Smith & Wesson, serial S71893.
Got all its, oh no, two.
Two rounds fired. And instead of dropping it down a drain, our shooter hoists it up here. Interesting guy.
Hmm. All right.
We should follow up on this now, before the perp tries to leave town.
Okay, file clues will be added to your notebook and can be viewed any time. Press to open the notebook. Clues? Found the revolver. Okay. And the blood stain. And these are the people. Okay, good to go. Good to go. Wait, what's that intuition thing? What is that? What's that? Intuition points are gained as you earn experience and rank. Use intuition points to aid your investigation. Okay. Did I just hear a cat meow? Well, I am in an alley.
We have the gun, Cole.
Climb it down.
Let's take it back to Central. We could get a commendation.
Could show some initiative, Ralph, and see if we can come up with an owner.
That's a long shot, Cole.
It's a pretty fancy gun. You know a local gun store?
Sure. There's a place a couple of blocks from here.
Use the notebook to set your next destination. Okay. We want to look at locations. Gun store. Wait. Gun store. 367 South Central. Oh, set as destination. Set as current destination. Okay.
So are you sure about this? Store. It's not really our gig.
No harm in doing some digging. The suits didn't seem to give much of a damn.
Such a little Boy Scout, Cole. You can't wait to get out of that uniform, can you?
You'd rather round up drunks and help old ladies across the road?
I'd rather get through the day without the captain's foot up my ass.
It'll be fine, Ralph.
Okay,
you worry
to see
too
if
much.
Anything else we might have missed? And we're good to go. Anything? I'm not getting that tingly. Not getting that tingly feeling.
Wake up, Cole.
Oh, put a sock in it, dude. I'm trying to be thorough. Trying to be a good cop, okay? Trying to do my job. Stop, man. Especially since I'm the man.
Tower. Continue to respond.
Officers Phelps and Dunn, can you tell us anything about this gun?
Smith & Wesson, Model 27, registered Magnum. Chambered for .357, nickel-plated with pearl grips. Same gun used by General Patton.
You're not suggesting he's the owner?
No, I'm not.
You seem to know a lot about the weapon.
I ought to. I sold it. You know, this piece will stop a rhino. These babies are only available special order. Here's my Smith & Wesson order book.
You mind if I take a look?
Be my guest. This is about something bad, right?
Back in the day,
this Model game... 27 with pearl grips, Cole. You see it on there?
Back in the day, the technology on this was kind of groundbreaking, because I think every voice actor in this game lent their voice to the character. The lead detective I'm playing now is Aaron Staton, and he played a character called Ken Cosgrove on Mad Men. And I was looking over the voice actors in this game. There are at least 4 or 5 actors in this game who are also in Mad Men, so it's really kind of interesting to have that many people from one source be voice actors in one project. Pearl Grip, here we go.
We're in luck. Errol Schroeder, 203 South Gless Street, ordered the gun in February 46. Thanks, you've been a big help.
Anytime. Always happy to help out the LAPD.
Now, do I have to put that in my book? Locations? Schroeder's apartment. Set its destination. There we go. And we're good to go.
Do we call it in?
Let's see if he's at home. Owning the gun doesn't prove he pulled the trigger.
This is true.
Okay. In for a penny, in for a pound. Lead the way, Gunga Dan.
So hard, was it? Just because we're in uniform doesn't mean we can't use our initiative.
I guess so. Seems a little too good to be true. One-of-a-kind murder weapon bought locally using the real name? If Schroeder's our shooter, he's no criminal mastermind.
Most of them aren't. That's why they get caught. And 2 out of every 3 crimes are done on impulse.
Another fact from the Phelps Encyclopedia of Thin Air. You really are full of it. Watch it!
Is that where we're going? Or are we going here? This is where we're going. Yeah, this is where we're going. Number two.
Schroeder, apartment two. What do you guys want?
I'm Officer Cole Phelps. This is Officer Dunn, Wilshire Division. You're the owner of a Smith & Wesson Model 27, nickel-plated with pearl grips?
I might be. What of it?
Then you'll be surprised to know that Scooter Payton was murdered tonight with your gun.
Oh,
you're
no,
out of your mind.
Not Scooter!
Scooter? He works for me. I have that gun here in my drawer.
You did?
What the fuck is going on here?
You're under arrest, Schroeder. Cuff him, Ralph.
No way! You're not taking me down for this.
Uh-oh.
You ready, tough guy?
Oh, I get the back of my boom, boom, boom. Take it. Take it. Take it. Ah, oh, take it. Take it. Stop fighting. Stop resisting. Stop resisting arrest. Stop resisting arrest. Oh! Nice. Stay down. Stay down. Nice.
Ralph, you all right?
I'm fine. I hardly felt it. It's lucky you caught me off guard.
I hardly felt it, yeah.
Keep an eye on him, Ralph. I'm gonna take a look around.
Artie Rosenberg, 50. Summers, 20. Frank Greer, 40. Oh, is he a bookie? These look like bets. Look like money. Maybe he was a bookie.
List of names and a series of numbers. Floyd Rose's name is in this book.
Phelps, we can come out of this all bright and shiny with a commendation. Or stick our schlongs in a hornet's nest. Call it in, partner.
I would not recommend
it. Leave the book where you found it.
Officer Phelps, badge 1247, requesting.
Okay, I gotta figure out what's up. Can I pause this? Okay, good. Options. Options. Gameplay controls. Okay, the controls seem fine. Sound, subtitles. Yeah, let's turn the subtitles on. Display. Oh, you can play this in black and white. Nice. Just like a noir film. That's kind of cool. Camera. Automation on. Off. Okay. Now I want to get this thing settled here. I don't understand why it keeps... telling me it keeps telling me it's recording. I want to get this done, see if I can rectify this real quick, because that's getting on my nerves. Okay, options. Okay, quit. All right. No, 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 no. No, I don't want to exit. Okay, we want to go back. I have no idea what she's doing. Fresh recruits at the police academy. Ah.
You dumb fucking sons of bitches! Get in this line now before I lose my temper!
Excuse me, Sergeant, but...
Excuse me? Fuck you! You say another word and I'll break your fucking head and have you in the brig!
Some of us are here for...
I know why you're here, asswipe! I'm having a bad day, Private. Some people don't seem to want to get on this bus.
I didn't ask for your help.
He didn't ask for your help. Can you believe this guy? Who are you two? Abbott and Costello?
We're here for OCS, Sergeant.
So it's the three fucking stooges and you're here for OCS. God help this fucking country and the USMC. The Japanese will do the world a favor and kill you quickly. All three of you are on report. What are your fucking names?
Phelps. Damn. Kelso.
Merrill.
Any other gentlemen for OCS? OCS is at Elliott. You take the Camp Elliott bus over there. This bus is for MCRD. This bus is for men who want to fight.
Jeez. Hey, do you want to take the stick out of your ass? But that's their job. They have to be assholes. Drill sergeants have to be assholes. Terrible.
Well, you picked the right place, Cole. A city that needed an honest cop like a thirsty man needed water. You'd heard the stories, but you weren't interested. You were here to fight the good fight, solve cases, right wrongs. But the force is like politics. There's no sitting on the fence.
Right.
You have to choose sides. A brown paper envelope or a Greyhound ticket to Palookaville. It could only ever end.
All
units at 211 in progress and shots fired at Westlake Savings and Loan, 1415 West 3rd Street. Unit to handle identifying code 3.
We'll take that. It's only a couple blocks from
14
here.
Adam calling KGPL. We'll handle the 211.
Roger that, 14 Adam. Be advised suspects are armed and dangerous.
Roger, KGPL.
Yeah, but so
14 Adam on route.
Make it quick, you guys. The cops are here. We gotta move it.
The bank is surrounded. I'm offering you
not
a chance to...
Chance, you come any closer, we'll cut you in.
We don't know how many are in there. Take it slow. Backup will be here soon.
Oh, where's your buddy?
That's it?
That's your
we got
ass.
Them all? I think we got them, Cole.
That's your ass, son.
Should be all clear. Lieutenant Hopkins says anytime you reach for the shotguns, you're either going to end up dead or wearing a citation. So I guess...
It's okay, Ralph. You did well in there. I'm glad you have my back. Man couldn't ask for a better partner.
Aww. Yes, nice. Man, that has got to be some kind of... not going to restart the game. So.
This kind of opportunity comes along once in a lifetime, Hank. I have to grasp it.
You have to survive at first, Cole. Here are the veterans. The Japs love to shoot officers.
If I can make a name for myself in this war, my future...
Thinking of taking on a company of the Emperor's finest single-handed? Huh. You don't seem the Sergeant York type to me.
When I need your opinion, Kelso, I'll ask for it.
They talk about officers like you in boot camp, Cole. They call it the Custer Syndrome. Guys who go around dreaming of fame and glory and getting all of their men killed in the process.
Our duty is to lead, Kelso.
And their duty is to die for your wonderful future?
Wow. So I'm guessing this is pretty much the story of what happened to these...
Cole Phelps and Jack Kelso. Here we go. With some people, it's as simple as chemistry. Two guys who should have been friends, but their personalities got in the way. Phelps, a good guy, wound way too tight. And Kelso, a quiet man who could never walk away from a fight.
Well, it's a shame you don't like to talk about it, Cole.
Ralph, this friends who want to stay like friends don't discuss like religion or politics. And in my case, you can add the war to that.
Dreamland, the whole season.
I know that bum. Wendell Bowers. I put him away before he jumped parole. Get after him, Phelps. I'll head him off in the car.
Wendell Bowers! Stop! LAPD!
You can go screw yourself. Why, you! He's hiding in the alley! Bowers! Hold
hey,
it right there!
I just want to talk!
Stop now or I will shoot! I won't tell you again, Wendell.
I just want to talk
Jesus,
to you.
Gun! Watch your fire!
You don't want to do this, Wendell. Get down from there right now!
Is that any way
Give it up, Wendell!
Hell?
Stay the hell away from me!
Oh, you dick!
You've got to be kidding!
You fucking asked for it.
Oh, I was just trying to be nice, but if I catch you, I'll beat your ass.
Go away, I'm going back inside.
Where'd he go? Where'd he go? Oh!
I've done my time.
Oh, I lost him. Oh!
You asshole.
Damn it! Oh, there we go. Okay, there we go. Where'd he go? This way.
It's over, Bowers!
Where'd he go? Where'd he go? Where'd he go? There he is.
Give it up, Bowers! There's nowhere left to go!
Oh, ah! Clothesline!
Looks like we've got the place to ourselves.
I'm beating your ass now, but...
How you doing, Wendell? Your parole officer's feeling lonely. He's got a hole in his life for an asshole like you. You can make it up to him in 10 years' time. Watch your head. This hump will be back in the Iron Hotel by tomorrow night.
The Iron Hotel.
Nice work, Cole. You run track in high school?
The Iron Hotel. That's funny.
Part of the tradition of the Marine Corps and being an officer in the Marine Corps is the ability to make tough decisions. The right decision is not always the popular one. The right decision will get the men you care about killed. These ratings and your ability to give them frankly and truthfully directly affect your chances of successfully becoming a Marine officer. Candidate Phelps, you have the floor. Esprit de Corps. Merrill, 10. Franklin, 8. Weiss, 8. Donahoe, 6. Kowalski, 6. Hudson, 5. Kelso, 2. Leadership. Donahoe, 8. Franklin, 7. Merrill, 6. Kowalski, 6. Weiss, 5. Hudson, 5. Kelso, 1.
I guess Kelso.
Candidate Kelso.
On the totem pole. Or is that a good
I'm
thing?
Sorry, Captain, but I joined the Marine Corps to fight the enemy, not get involved in this schoolboy chicken shit.
Kelso, in my office, now!
You somebody in trouble.
For every cop, there's the case that makes you. Gives you that leg up, gets you recognized as the shining new star in the squad. The case that you solve that shows that you have the gumption, the gung-ho, the get-up-and-go to make you stand out from your average rank-and-file patrolman. This could be the one, Cole.
Oh, the banter. Love it. Love it, love it.
LAPD, could you stand clear of the body, please? Has anyone called an ambulance?
We've called an ambulance and the police, but I'm afraid he's dead.
Okay, stand further back or move along. It's your choice, but make it quick, people.
Hey, Cole.
What's up, dudes?
You got here quick.
My beat crosses 7th Street.
Okay. Your first reporting, then. We'll get a perimeter going and move the crowd on. You better see what you can find out before the homicide dicks show up. I'll be with you in a moment.
Broad daylight, crowded street. Now I've seen everything.
Everybody stay back. Let us do our job.
What's he got in his pockets? Bank of Arcadia. Pearl earrings. Ooh. Huh. Payments made. Sale slip. Pocket? No, I guess not. Okay, what's here? Nothing there. No,
All right. Yes, it's a dead person.
Hey, I'm just doing my job here, you know? So I guess that's the only clue to be found on him?
Shell casings. These look like 32s. This is a secure area. Sir, I'm Officer Phelps. What exactly did you see?
I heard the shots. I thought it was a car backfiring. I saw a girl run into the shoe store.
You want to take a look around now? The witness can wait, Cole. We've got the perimeter.
No, I'm going to go talk to her.
We should make sure we've checked the whole crime scene before questioning the witness.
Okay.
Can I help you, sir?
Okay, the whole crime scene. Okay, I've looked at the body. I've checked. Oh, the garbage can. Yep. The gun. is in the garbage can. Okay.
FN Browning. Serial number 01138. Might need to run it by a gun store.
Browning, that's a
serial. Eagleson's gun store is a couple blocks from here.
Officer Phelps, miss. I'm here about the shooting. Did you know the victim?
He was my boss. Mr. Gage.
Mr. Gage's first name?
Everett.
And you are?
Galleta.
Hello, name, Clovis. Second name. Welcome Galleta. To the stream. Are listed on the right. Okay, I wasn't even paying attention. Use R to observe the suspect. Okay, what was that? I was not looking. What was I supposed to do? Shoe store clerk. Okay, there we go. Okay, I will get the eyewitness account.
Do you think you could tell me exactly what happened, miss?
I look around the shops at lunch. I was in a store when Mr. Gage, my boss, bursts in yelling that I'm late on my lunch.
And?
We came back. I was angry. I walked in front. I heard shots. I turned and saw Mr. Gage fall.
If you think the witness is lying and you have proof, choose accuse. To accuse a witness, you will need to present evidence. I think she's lying, but I can't accuse her because... Okay, what was outside? The shell casings and the gun was in the trash. She said that she was...
I'm having a hard time believing that, young lady. Do you want to be taken to a police cell?
You're hardly any older than me. Don't you dare talk to me that way.
A man is dead, Miss Galetta, and it's a criminal offense to lie to a police officer. I'll
yeah,
take
it is.
You downtown.
Get out! Get out right now!
Uh-oh.
Send in one of the other policemen if you must, but I won't say another word to you.
Uh-oh. Oh, shit. I pissed her off. Maybe she was telling the truth. Oh, damn. Can I apologize to her? I guess I can't. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. I think I screwed up. I'm a bad cop.
We have the murder weapon?
I'm a bad
murder.
Cop.
Girl saw it all, but she clammed up on me. We could trace the gun.
Eagleson's gun store is a couple blocks from here.
You thinking what I'm thinking?
Tate, maintain the perimeter.
I think so, Brian. You pondering what I'm pondering? Thank you. You pondering what I'm pondering? Can I go? Oh. Case failed. Oh, crime scene contaminated. What? How? What did I do? Okay. Oh, so does this mean I can interrogate her again? Okay, do I have to go through all of these? Okay, maybe that means I can interrogate her again. Galetta, apartment S. Okay, pearl earrings, etc., etc., etc. Layaway ticket number, haha. I didn't
see
scroll
Galetta.
Down far enough to see that.
Layaway receipt, pearl earrings made out to Bank of Arcadia.
I didn't scroll down far enough for that, okay. All right. We've looked over the body. We've looked over the face, we've looked over, but I may have to do it again. Check this hand. Okay. Okay. Nothing there. Nothing there. Maybe I failed it because I blew. Well, it said crime scene contaminated. He's having a smoke. He's having a smoke. Let's open the book and see what he's got. Okay, so I've got a layaway voucher, shell casing, Browning. Okay, we've got all that. Got that. Locations. The gun store. Okay. Okay, so why does it say crime scene contaminated? I don't understand. Can I interrogate her again? Is that why it's contaminated? Because I blew the... No? Okay. All right. I wonder why it said crime scene contaminated. What did I do?
What did I tell you about going too hard on the witness? She's a store assistant, not a prisoner of war.
Is that supposed to be funny?
I'm just saying that sometimes you need to pour some sugar on these broads. A little bedside manner can go a long way.
And since when are you the expert? We got the murder weapon, didn't we?
You shouldn't dole it out if you can't take it, Phelps. She was a looker, though. Tell me I'm wrong.
No wonder you're suddenly so obsessed with bedside manner.
You gonna leave a street light intact on this block? No, you did not just do that!
Oh, did I hit somebody? Did I hurt him? Hello, Adam.
Officers, what can I do you for?
Officers Phelps and Dunn, sir, Wilshire Division. We need you to trace a serial number.
Sure. What's the make and model?
F.N. Browning, model 1922. The serial number is 01138.
You don't say. Well, I didn't sell it. Europeans love them, but it's pretty rare you find one over here. Although I did have one in here a couple of weeks back.
Remember the owner?
Yeah. Callu. Edgar Callu was his name. Uh-huh. Thing looks like he'd never been fired, but he brought it in here for cleaning anyway. And he bought a box of cartridges and he left.
Do you know where we can find Mr. Callu?
Told me he was on his lunch break. Said he worked at Hartfield's jewelry store just up on Broadway.
Thanks for your help.
Okay. got the clue. Okay. Wait. Okay, let's go check this guy out. Dude just stops for a smoke every time I stop. What's up with that?
Officer Newtown, 103 and
D. Get in the car! Get in the car, jackass! Get in the car!
Hey, Cole, let's get moving.
Yeah. Put a sock in it.
Officer, can I interest you in a new watch?
No.
Officer Cole Phelps, are you Edgar Kalu?
No. Mr. Kalu is out back. He said he'd lie down.
Mm-hmm.
I'll buzz him for you.
Uh-huh. Why do I know he's lying?
Son of a bitch! Go, Cole, go! Kalu, get back here!
I'm not gonna shoot.
Too late, Kalu!
I shouldn't have shot him. Damn it. But the game was telling me to point and shoot, but, you know, I should have used my...
Officer Cole Phelps, are you Edgar Kalu?
No. Mr. Kalu is out back. He said he'd lie down. I'll buzz him for you.
Son of a bitch! Go, Cole, go! Kalu, get back here!
You recommend it?
Too late, Kalu! Worse, Kalu.
Oh, I can run. No. Okay, so what do I do now?
Edgar Kalu, you're under arrest for the murder of Everett Gage.
The case that makes you, and the case that breaks you. The one you never solved, The one that keeps you awake at night.
Seems too easy, right?
The case that gnaws at your guts and ruins your marriage. The case that keeps you propping up a bar as you relive the what-ifs, the might-have-beens, the half-leads, and the half-truths.
Nice.
The case that other cops murmur about whenever you walk past. The case you never, ever discuss.
God's mill may grind slowly, but it grinds finely, son. Wow. I hear it's you who nabbed our malefactor from the shooting yesterday.
Yes, sir.
Then tell me, Boyle. I hear you're quite the climber, a man of initiative. How would you like a chance at smiting this man with the sword of justice?
You're asking me to conduct the interview, sir?
I am, young Phelps. You've only been with us a short time, and you've assembled yourself a stellar arrest record. Not to mention the fine work you did in the war, sending heathens back to the hell they came from. But I'm curious as to whether you can turn your hand to interrogation.
Yeah, me too.
Takes a certain animal cunning, lad. Do you think you might be ready for that?
Yes, sir. I think I am.
Good man. You need many things for a conviction, young Phelps.
Proof.
A motive, opportunity, hard evidence, and best of all, a confession. If you fail in the former, you can always use a modicum of violence to obtain the latter.
Oh, in other words, I could smack him.
How are you
up?
Feeling, lad?
Fine, sir.
You telling me I could smack him?
Very good.
Is that what you're telling
me? The evidence is overwhelming. May the cat eat him and the cat be eaten by the devil. Bring me a confession, young Phelps. This is your chance. Don't fail me.
I hope not, because my last interrogation didn't go so well. But this guy, is he guilty? It would be too.
Has my lawyer arrived yet? I want to see my lawyer.
A lawyer can't help you, Mr. Kalu. You shot a man dead in cold blood. You're going to have to pay for that.
Casings, Browning handgun, layaway voucher, murder weapon service. Let's go, okay. Okay, so how do we ask him?
Let's talk about the shooting. Do you deny shooting Everett Gage?
I'm a businessman. I run a jewelry store. I don't know what you're talking about. I'm sure my lawyer can clear all this up.
He looks a little nervous about something. Let's be nice to him for a minute, see what happens.
Come on, Mr. Kalu. Make this easier on yourself.
Oh.
Get it off your conscience.
You think I'm stupid?
I screwed
think I'll
something
just
up.
Do yeah. whatever you want because you're a nice guy. I've just got to keep my mouth shut and watch you run around in circles. We're done. Unless you want to keep making a schmuck of yourself.
Oh, man!
You disappoint me, Cole Phelps.
Yeah. Disappointed myself.
Get back in there and raise some lumps, boy! I need a confession!
Dude! The fuck? Dude!
Has my lawyer arrived yet? I want to see my lawyer.
Oh, I can't do over. All right.
A lawyer can't help you, Mr. Kalu. You shot a man dead in cold blood. You're going to have to pay for that.
Okay, so I get a do-over. All right.
Let's talk about the shooting. Do you deny shooting Everett Gage?
I'm a businessman. I run a jewelry store. I don't know what you're talking about. I'm sure my lawyer can clear all this up.
He looks nervous, but everybody would look nervous if they're being interviewed by the cops. And he looks a little confused. If he were guilty, you'd think he'd like be sweating or whatever. I have an intuition point, so let's try it. How do we remove an answer? Oh, remove an answer. Okay. All right, let's try this. Damn it.
Come on, Mr. Kalu.
Oh, I did the same thing.
Make this easier on yourself. Get it off your conscience.
You think I'm stupid? You think I'll just do whatever you want because you're a nice guy? I've just got to keep my mouth shut and watch you run around in circles.
I did the same thing.
We're done.
Before. All right.
Unless you want to keep making a schmuck of yourself.
Damn it. Now he's going to yell at me again.
You disappoint me, Cole Phelps.
Yeah.
Get back in there and raise some lumps, boy! I need a confession!
Oh, raise some lumps. Oh, he wants me to smack him up. Okay. Alright. He wants me to smack him up.
Has my lawyer arrived yet? I want to see my lawyer.
A lawyer can't help you, Mr. Kalu. You shot a man dead in cold blood. You're going to have to pay for that. Let's talk about the shooting. Do you deny shooting Everett Gage?
I'm a businessman. I run a jewelry store. I don't know what you're talking about. I'm sure my lawyer can clear all this up.
Okay.
You blew a man out of his socks over an empty grudge, you
what?
Son of a bitch. Do you think I have sympathy for you?
That's the way. Keep needling me. Try the rough stuff, and my lawyer will be making an official complaint.
Damn
I've just
it.
Got to keep my mouth shut and watch you run around in circles. We're done. Unless you want to keep making a schmuck of yourself.
Damn it. Okay, I was nice to him. I was hard on him.
You disappoint me, Cole Phelps. Get back in there and raise some lumps, boy! I need a confession!
Okay, so I'm missing something. I'm obviously not doing something right.
Has my lawyer arrived yet? I want to see my lawyer.
A lawyer can't help you, Mr. Kalu. You shot a man dead in cold blood. You're going to have to pay for that. Let's talk about the shooting. Do you deny shooting Everett Gage?
I'm a businessman. I run a jewelry store. I don't know what you're talking about. I'm sure my lawyer can clear all this up.
He had the weapon. Okay, the store owner said that the guy came in, so. He seems pretty cool.
Didn't I ask for a lawyer? Shouldn't you be on the phone, officer?
How do you turn the pages of the book? How do you turn the pages of the book again? Let's accuse him.
You deny owning a Browning pistol, serial number 01138.
I owned a gun, yes, but it was stolen in a burglary a couple years ago. You can't prove I used my gun on Gage.
You had the gun cleaned and bought a new box of ammunition. The store owner remembers you and where you were.
Is that so? It's amazing what the nebbishes will recall when it suits them.
Ha.
Let's change the subject. You fasting for Yom Kippur, Mr. Kalu?
Yeah, let's change the subject, you going motherfucker! How about baseball?
You're not denying you're a Jew, Mr. Kalu.
This is America. It's not Germany. It's not a crime.
Some people don't like Jews, Mr. Kalu.
Yeah, and I guess you're one of them.
Gage hated Jews, didn't he, Mr. Kalu?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Gage. let's try the I want to choose the right thing. I want to choose the right thing. I don't want to piss this guy off. Ah, damn it.
Gage was a Jew hater. Get it off your chest.
Gage and his kind are pathetic. I've just got to keep my mouth shut and watch you run around in circles.
Damn We're done. It.
Unless you want to keep making a schmuck of yourself.
Ah, shit. Is he gonna yell at me again?
You disappoint
yes.
me, Cole Phelps. Get back in there and raise some lumps, boy!
Okay!
I need a confession!
I know I can't have any pudding if I don't eat my meat. I get it, all right? Stand still, Lenny! That's
Has what my lawyer sounds arrived like yet? I want to see my lawyer.
A lawyer can't help you, Mr. Kalu.
Hey, Sauce Boss,
you shot
how
a man
you
dead in cold blood. You're going to have to pay for that.
Damn it.
Let's talk about the shooting. Do you deny shooting Everett Gage?
I'm a businessman. I run a jewelry store. I don't know what you're talking about. I'm sure my lawyer can clear all this up.
A jewelry store. Wait, a jewelry store. A jewelry store. And that guy had a,
You deny owning a Browning pistol. Serial number 01138.
I owned a gun, yes, but it was stolen in a burglary a couple years ago. You can't prove I used my gun on Gage.
What do you mean? How did I do the stream? What do you mean? I don't understand what you mean. Okay, I want to talk about that voucher.
Gage was an asshole, but his death wasn't down to me. I've just got to keep my mouth shut and watch you run around in circles. We're done. Unless you want to keep making a schmuck of yourself.
Okay, this is going to be a trial by fire, isn't
it? You disappoint me, Cole Phelps.
Get back in there and raise some lumps, boy!
Yeah.
I need a confession!
Yeah, okay, I'm working on it. Don't get your balls in a twist, Jacko.
Has my lawyer arrived yet? I want to see my lawyer.
A lawyer can't help you, Mr. Kalu. You shot a man dead in cold blood. You're going to have to pay for that.
Yep.
Let's talk about the shooting. Do you deny shooting Everett Gage?
I'm a businessman. I run a jewelry store. I don't know what you're talking about. I'm sure my lawyer can clear all this up.
I did that with OBS. The color strips that you see, I got them free from a website that had overlays. And all the text that you see, I put on there with OBS. Okay, we want to accuse him.
You deny owning a Browning pistol. Serial That's number right 01138.
I owned a gun, yes, but it was stolen in a burglary a couple years ago. You can't prove I used my gun on Gage.
Years ago, okay, yeah, dude said you had it serviced.
You had the gun cleaned and bought a new box of ammunition. The store owner remembers you and where you were.
Is that so? It's amazing what the nebbishes will recall when it suits them.
New lead, possible religious.
Let's change the subject. You fasting for Yom Kippur, Mr. Kalu?
Yeah, let's change the subject, you going motherfucker! How about baseball?
You're not denying you're a Jew, Mr. Kalu.
This is America, it's not Germany. It's not a crime.
Some people don't like Jews, Mr. Kalu.
Yeah, and I guess you're one of them.
Gage hated Jews, didn't he, Mr. Kalu?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Gage hated How do I look at the... Okay, we know, Cora. Didn't I ask him about that already and it wasn't the right question? Oh, man. What can I... Okay, I asked him about that and I asked him about that. Oh, what can I ask him? It's not letting me change pages in the book. Yeah, I tried Good Cop though. But this is another question. I tried Good Cop. And yeah, it's incorrect.
Gage was a Jew hater. Get it off your chest.
Gage and his kind are pathetic. I've just got to keep my mouth shut and watch you run around in circles. We're done. Unless you want to keep making a schmuck of yourself.
You disappoint me, Cole Phelps.
Get back in there and raise some lumps, boy! I need a confession!
How can you have any pudding if you don't eat, Jimmy? Yes.
Has my lawyer arrived yet? I want to see my lawyer.
A lawyer can't help you, Mr. Cullough.
I'm sorry, that's all I hear in
my head.
You shot
a man dead in
screaming.
Cold blood. You're going to have to pay for that.
Damn it. Let's talk about
shooting. Let's talk about the shooting. Do you deny shooting Everett Gage?
I'm a businessman. I run a jewelry store. I don't know what you're talking about. I'm sure my lawyer can clear all this up.
Okay, we want to look at the notebook, and I want to ask him about that. Yes. Accused.
You deny owning a Browning pistol, serial number 01138.
I owned a gun, yes, but it was stolen in a burglary a couple years ago. You can't prove I used my gun on Gage.
No, it's not based on a Holocaust. It's not based on a Holocaust.
You had the gun cleaned and bought a new box of ammunition. The store owner remembers you and where you work.
Is that so? It's amazing what the nebbishes will recall when it suits them.
Possible religious motive. But what do I do after that?
Let's change the subject. You fasting for Yom Kippur, Mr. Cullen?
Yeah, let's change the subject, you going motherfucker! How about baseball?
You're not denying you're a Jew, Mr. Cullen.
This is America. It's not Germany. It's not a crime.
Some people don't like Jews, Mr. Cullen.
Yeah, and I guess you're one of them.
Gage hated Jews, didn't he, Mr. Cullen?
I don't know what you're talking about.
There's gotta be more questions than I can ask him. I'm kind of stuck here. You know, I have a feeling this might have something to do with the interrogation of... Okay, Sauce, I'll see you. Good, I'm glad you stopped by. I have a feeling this has something to do with any questions that I could have asked the witness in the shoe store because I ended up pissing her off and she wouldn't talk to me anymore. So now I'm like, what can I do? What can I do? I already asked him about the gun. I already asked that a question about the voucher. But...
didn't I ask for a lawyer?
Yeah.
Shouldn't you be on the phone, officer?
What can I do? What can I do? Evidence. This is evidence. This is evidence. How can I...
You're lying, Kalu. I think you lent Gage money, and he owed you payment.
I don't know what you're talking about.
The layaway voucher, yeah.
I'm done with you. Go flap your gum somewhere else. I want my lawyer.
Oh, come on.
I've just got to keep my mouth shut and watch you run around in circles. We're done.
I got one question right.
Unless you want to keep making a schmuck of yourself.
This is killing me.
You disappoint me, Cole Phelps.
Man,
get back in there and
raise
some lunch, boy!
No.
I need a confession!
And I bet you it's because I blew the interrogation of that girl. I bet that's why. Oh, I bet that's why they're going to make this difficult for me. Son of a bitch.
Has my lawyer arrived yet? I want to see my lawyer.
A lawyer can't help you, Mr. Kalu. You shot a man dead
Anybody's
in cold blood.
Tips,
you're going to
tricks,
have to pay for
help.
That.
I'm all for it. Okay. Review evidence. Let's try that.
I've just got to keep my mouth shut and watch you run around in circles.
Wait, we're done.
Unless you want to keep making a schmuck of yourself.
Anything.
You disappoint me, Cole Phelps.
Yeah.
Get back in there and raise some lumps, boy! I need a confession!
Keep barking, you junkyard dog. I'm trying to do it. God.
Has my lawyer arrived yet? I want to see my lawyer.
A lawyer can't help you, Mr. Kalu. You shot a man dead in cold blood. You're going to have to pay for that. Let's talk about the shooting. Do you deny shooting Everett Gage?
I'm a businessman. I run a jewelry store. I don't know what you're talking about. I'm sure my lawyer can clear all this up.
You deny owning a Browning pistol, serial number 01138.
I owned a gun, yes, but it was stolen in a burglary a couple years ago. You can't prove I used my gun on Gage.
You had the gun cleaned and bought a new box of ammunition. The store owner remembers you and where you were.
Is that so? It's amazing what the nebbishes will recall when it suits them.
Can I use...
I've just got to keep my mouth shut and watch you run around in circles. We're done. Unless you want to keep making a schmuck of yourself.
Come on! What the hell?
You disappoint me, Cole Phelps.
Get back in there and raise some lumps, boy! I need a confession!
Okay.
Has my lawyer arrived yet? I want to see my lawyer.
A lawyer can't help you, Mr. Kalu. You shot a man dead in cold blood. You're going to have to pay for that. Let's talk about the shooting. Do you deny shooting Everett Gage?
I'm a businessman. I run a jewelry store. I don't know what you're talking about.
This is killing me.
I'm sure my lawyer can clear all this up.
Oh yeah, I've already used my intuition.
You deny owning a Browning pistol, serial number 01138.
I owned a gun, yes, but it was stolen in a burglary a couple years ago. You can't prove I used my gun on Gage.
Okay, so now what? Oh, wait, he had it serviced.
You had the gun cleaned and bought a new box of ammunition. The store owner remembers you and where you worked.
Is that so? It's amazing what the Nebbishes will recall when it suits them.
Possible religious motive.
I've just got to keep my mouth shut and watch you run around in circles. We're done. Unless you want to keep making a schmuck of yourself.
I can only ask him one question. There's nothing else that they will respond
to. You disappoint me, Cole Phelps.
What the hell?
Get back in there and raise some lumps, boy! I need a confession!
Damn it! I swear to God, this is probably because I blew that interrogation with that chick.
Has my lawyer arrived yet? I want to see my lawyer.
If anybody
a lawyer can't
has
help you, Mr. Kalu. You shot a man dead in cold blood. You're going to have to pay for that.
I haven't tried it yet. Oh my God. Let's try this.
Let's talk about the shooting. Do you deny shooting Everett Gage?
I'm a businessman. I run a jewelry store. I don't know what you're talking about. I'm sure my lawyer can clear all this up.
You deny owning a Browning pistol, serial number 01138.
I owned a gun, yes, but it was stolen in a burglary a couple years ago. You can't prove I used my gun on Gage.
You had the gun cleaned and bought a new box of ammunition. The store owner remembers you and where you were.
Is that so? It's amazing what the Nebbishes will recall when it suits them. I've just got to keep my mouth shut and watch you run around in circles. We're done. Unless you want to keep making a schmuck of yourself.
Oh, come on!
You disappoint me, Cole Phelps.
One more time.
Get back in there and raise some lungs, boy!
I
need a confession!
This is getting on my nerves. This is starting to bug me now.
Has my lawyer arrived yet? I want to see my lawyer.
A lawyer can't help you, Mr. Kalu. You shot a man dead in cold blood. You're going to have to pay for that.
Okay.
Let's talk about the shooting. Do you deny shooting Everett Gage?
I'm a businessman. I run a jewelry store. I don't know what you're talking about. I'm sure my lawyer can clear all this up.
You deny owning a Browning pistol, serial number 01138.
I owned a gun, yes, but it was stolen in a burglary a couple years ago. You can't prove I used my gun on Gage.
You had the gun cleaned and bought a new box of ammunition. The store owner remembers you and where you were.
Is that so? It's amazing what the nebbishes will recall when it suits them.
Let's change the subject. You fasting for Yom Kippur, Mr. Kalu?
Yeah, let's change the subject, you going motherfucker! How about baseball?
You're not denying you're a Jew, Mr. Kalu.
This is America. It's not Germany. It's not a crime.
Some people don't like Jews, Mr. Kalu.
Yeah, and I guess you're one of them.
Gage hated Jews, didn't he, Mr. Kalu?
I don't know what you're talking about.
I tried the good cop, I tried the bad cop, and I think I've tried all three of these things. And I get the same...
You're lying, Kalu. I think you lent Gage money, and he owed you payment.
I don't know what you're talking about. I'm done with you. Go flap your gum somewhere else. I want my lawyer. I've just got to keep my mouth shut and watch you run around in circles. We're done. Unless you want to keep making a schmuck of yourself.
The religious motive was I was right up to that point. I was right
you
up
You disappoint
to that
me,
point.
Cole Phelps.
Get back in there and raise some lumps, boy!
Yeah,
I need a confession!
Yeah, junkyard dog. Okay, it's Groundhog Day for me in this game.
Has
right
my
now.
Lawyer arrived yet? I want to see my lawyer.
Totally
a lawyer can't
Day.
Help you, Mr. Kalu. You shot a man
Anybody
dead in cold blood.
Ideas?
You're going to have to pay for that.
I'm open hearing.
Let's talk about the shooting. Do you deny shooting Everett Gage?
I'm a businessman. I run a jewelry store. I don't know what you're talking about. I'm sure my lawyer can clear all this up.
You deny owning a Browning pistol, serial number 01138.
I owned a gun, yes, but it was stolen in a burglary a couple years ago. You can't prove I used my gun on Gage.
You had the gun cleaned and bought a new box of ammunition. The store owner remembers you and where you were.
Is that so? It's amazing what the nebbishes will recall when it suits them.
Right, let's change the subject.
Let's change the subject. You fasting for Yom Kippur, Mr. Kalu?
Yeah, let's change the subject, you going motherfucker! How about baseball?
You're not denying you're a Jew, Mr. Kalu.
This is America. It's not Germany. It's not a crime.
Some people don't like Jews, Mr. Kalu.
Yeah, and I guess you're one of them.
Gage hated Jews, didn't he, Mr. Kalu?
I don't know what you're talking about.
I can't remember what I asked before. Okay.
You're lying, Kalu. I think you lent Gage money, and he owed you payment.
I don't know what you're talking about.
And if I ask him about the voucher, then he clams up. If I ask him about the voucher, he clams up. Okay. Because we just talked about him owing money. Press circle to back out of an accusation. But if I back out of the accusation, that's going to shut him down and I have to start this process all over again, right?
nothing personal. I'm just doing my job. You understand that?
Okay. Okay. Do I ask him about the receipt? Just do that.
Damn! I'm done with you. Go flap your gum somewhere else. I want my lawyer. I've just got to keep my mouth shut and watch you run around in circles. We're done. Unless you want to keep making a schmuck of yourself.
Fuck!
You disappoint me, Cole.
Yeah,
folks.
I disappoint myself.
Get back in there and raise some lumps, boy! I need a confession!
It's Groundhog Day.
Has my lawyer arrived yet? I want to see my lawyer.
Wait, I don't care.
A lawyer can't help you, Mr. Kalu. You shot a man dead in cold blood. You're going to have to pay for that.
Oh, was I supposed to talk to somebody else first? Huh. Okay, hold on a second, guys. I want to look up something. And I don't care if you think it's cheating or not, because I don't want to be stuck on this. Okay, let's see what's going on.
Didn't I ask for a lawyer? Shouldn't you be on the phone, officer?
Yeah, put your keep your pants on.
Didn't I ask for a lawyer?
Okay.
Shouldn't you be on the phone, officer?
Gage, argument with Gage, possible religious motive, shooting incident. Okay, so,
let's talk about the shooting. Do you deny shooting Everett Gage?
I'm a businessman. I run a jewelry store. I don't know what you're talking about. I'm sure my lawyer can clear all this up.
Okay, he's lying. We know he's lying. Should I accuse...
You deny owning a Browning pistol, serial number 01138.
I owned a gun, yes, but it was stolen in a burglary a couple years ago. You can't prove I used my gun on Gage. Didn't I ask for a lawyer?
Sorry, my mistake.
Okay.
You had the gun cleaned and bought a new box of ammunition. The store owner remembers you and where you were.
Is that so? It's amazing what the nebbishes will recall when it suits them.
Let's change the subject. You fasting for Yom Kippur, Mr. Kalu?
Yeah, let's change the subject, you going motherfucker! How about baseball?
You're not denying you're a Jew, Mr. Kalu.
This is America. It's not Germany. It's not a crime.
Some people don't like Jews, Mr. Kalu.
Yeah, and I guess you're one of them.
Gage hated Jews, didn't he, Mr. Kalu?
I don't know what you're talking about.
There's something I'm missing somewhere. No, because if I choose backup, he'll shut down. I went through this already. Possible religious motive. We did through that.
You're lying, Kalu. I think you lent Gage money, and he owed you payment.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Sorry. Sometimes you have to shake the tree to see what falls out.
Gotta confess.
I'm done with you. Go flap your gum somewhere else. I want my lawyer. I've just got to keep my mouth shut and watch you run around in circles.
Oh,
we're done.
This is
unless you
want to
keep making a schmuck of yourself.
No matter what I do, I get the wrong answer.
You disappoint me, Cole Phelps.
Get back in there and raise some lumps, boy! I need a confession!
Has my lawyer arrived yet? I want to see my lawyer.
A lawyer can't help you, Mr. Kalu. You shot a man dead in cold blood. You're going to have to pay for that.
I've just got to keep my mouth shut and watch you run around in circles.
No.
We're done. Unless you want to keep making a schmuck of yourself.
Okay, I'm looking something up here, gang. I gotta find out how to get.
You disappoint me, Cole Phelps.
It's driving me nuts.
Get back in there and raise some lumps, boy! I need a confession!
Hold on. Can I restart this? Options. Clue music auto. Clue hints on. Action skip on. Yeah, let's make this. The chimes and the wireless controller. Yeah, there we go. That's a good thing. Music will automatically fade down when all clues in the location are discovered. Okay. You know what? I'm gonna all unsaved progress will be lost. I don't know how far into the game am I? I don't know how far back I will start. You know what? Hold on. Let's give it a shot. Hopefully I won't have to start all over again. Because I have a feeling something I did. Because I pissed that girl off in the store. And I couldn't interrogate her anymore. Maybe maybe it'll start me back there. I don't know. Because I just can't make heads or tails of this interrogation.
Has my lawyer arrived yet? I want to see my lawyer.
A lawyer can't help you, Mr. Kalu. You shot a man dead in cold blood. You're going to have to pay for that. Let's talk about the shooting. Do you deny shooting Everett Gage?
I'm a businessman. I run a jewelry store. I don't know what you're talking about. I'm sure my lawyer can clear all this up.
You deny owning a Browning pistol, serial number 01138.
I owned a gun, yes, but it was stolen in a burglary a couple years ago. You can't prove I used my gun on Gage.
You had the gun cleaned and bought a new box of ammunition. The store owner remembers you and where you work.
Is that so? It's amazing what the nebbishes will recall when it suits them.
Let's change the subject. You fasting for Yom Kippur, Mr. Kalu?
Yeah, let's change the subject, you going motherfucker! How about baseball?
You're not denying you're a Jew, Mr. Kalu.
This is America. It's not Germany. It's not a crime.
Some people don't like Jews, Mr. Kalu.
Yeah, and I guess you're one of them.
Gage hated Jews, didn't he, Mr. Kalu?
I don't know what you're talking about.
You left-wing-leaning parasite. You expect me to sit here and listen to your drivel?
You call me that? You sit there and you call me those names, you goddamn goy putt snatcher? You and that stump Gage!
Why did you do it, Mr. Kalu?
Gage. He's in the Chamber of Commerce. He's in with all those momsers. He blocked every proposal I ever put forward. Kike this and kike that. He's been trying to ruin my business for years.
Edgar Kalu, I'm charging you with the first-degree murder of Everett Gage. I respect your beliefs and your right to hold them. I hope for your sake, the jury can commute to murder in the second degree.
Damn.
May God have mercy on you, sir.
Damn. About friggin' time.
Masterfully done, Officer Phelps.
No bullshit.
It is just, Officer Phelps. Isn't it, lad?
Yes, sir.
Then let me have a word with the chief of police, young Phelps. The department needs heroes. A shining, honest face the public can admire. Oh, yeah. I applaud a man with your talent for unwavering justice.
Yeah, whatever.
Back to your duties for now, Boyle. But here's a piece of advice. Get yourself two suits, get them pressed. You'll be needing them.
Holy shit. Tells me I'm really gonna suck at interrogation. Police Academy. Prepare for reassignment. Okay. Keen interrogation instincts. My ass. Oh my god. Okay. Okay. Holy shit. I don't want to have to go through that Groundhog Day again, man. Snacky, snacky, snacky. Nah. Snacky, snacky, snacky. Snacky, snacky, snacky.
Here's your new desk, kid. You're on traffic. The hot sheet is posted here, next to the map.
What's his problem?
That's Biggs. He's an institution.
So this is what all the fuss is about. Why couldn't they build a freeway that goes past my place?
They haven't even approved the money yet, kid. The bond issue won't be till December. It'll be years before any of this will happen. Here's your new partner, Stefan Berkowski.
I've heard all about you, Phelps. You go easy on me and let me earn the odd citation, and maybe we'll get along fine. I'm here to learn, Detective.
He's an intense one, isn't he, Mel?
Who's intense?
The newly minted detective here, Cole Phelps.
Hi, Phelps. I'll be keeping an eye on you. I could spend a little time basking in reflected glory, make a change from busting hookers and dope fiends.
Who was that, Commander?
Roy Earle, chief detective and advice.
Do they all dress like movie stars?
Well, Roy is a movie star. And the whole of the seedy side of L.A. is his audience.
What is that supposed to mean?
Stick with me, kid. You'll find out.
And now some housekeeping. Warm Central Division welcome for Detective Cole Phelps. Some of you guys may know Phelps. He's the cop who broke the jewelry store murder. Stand up and take a bow, Phelps.
If it's all right with you,
that's
sir.
That's an order, Phelps.
Ooh.
Shh, quiet, everybody.
Phelps is one of only two serving LAPD officers who received the Silver Star during the war. Really gave it those lousy Japanese, eh, Phelps?
I did my best, Captain.
Why, you war hero is always so modest. I've partnered Phelps with everybody's favorite Pole, Stefan Bukowski.
Hope you like work, kid. Bukowski sure as hell doesn't.
Well, that's why we have partners, right?
Okay, can it, guys. Stick with Bukowski. He's a good cop. He knows traffic inside and out. I'm gonna start you out with one case. You do okay, I'll give you a couple more. You screw up, you'll be rousting vagrants and running license plates. Now get down to the P.E. Freight Depot, 6th and Alameda. A patrolman called in a suspicious vehicle. Signs of foul play. See what you can find out.
Come on, Phelps.
Time to make the donuts.
I didn't come to California.
They really pushed you through quick, didn't they? 6 years on patrol before I got this desk. You were here in 5 minutes.
What do you want me to say? I didn't ask for any favors.
I think his name is Phelps. I read about him in the newspaper.
Excuse me, pardon me, coming through. Excuse me. Where are we going? Oh, okay.
Canary says he'll sing.
Okay.
You know this place?
We got a
sure.
Shiny new car.
Near the old gas works and signal depot in the warehouse district. I'll direct.
Damn it! And the minute I get in it.
All units, a 459 just occurred at 6th
so,
and Saris.
Tell me a little about yourself, Phelps. Are we friends now, Bukowski? We have to work together. Don't be so touchy. I
grew up in San Francisco. My father was in shipping. Went to college at Stanford. Did 2 years ROTC before Marine OCS at Camp Elliott. Shipped out in early 45 as a first lieutenant, fought in the Okinawa campaign. Was wounded, shipped back home. Did a year on the beat, now I'm here.
So you won the Silver Star.
I don't want to talk about it.
Now let me get this straight. You
are you blind?
Yes.
Now, let me get this straight. You single-handedly killed 40 Japs on this hill in Okinawa.
No. You were up there all night, draped in the flag, knife between your teeth, gun at the ready. Finished?
Jeez, dude.
The Emperor Hirohito himself leading the charge against you.
I did my part, Bukowski. What did you do?
I kept the streets of L.A. safe.
All units, a 459 just occurred at 6th and Saris. Any unit to handle, code 2, identified.
You got a head full of nothing.
What's this screaming radio? Yeah, now I get it. unfit for service.
Now, fuck you, Phelps. I earned a bravery citation during the Zooter riots.
Sounds like you had it.
I really hope I don't get dinged for that music.
That you, Bukowski? Go on through. Parking lot straight ahead.
I need to get back to work, officer.
The detectives are here now. You repeat to them what you told me.
I did the right thing by calling this in. I'm just a working stiff.
Just give them your story and you'll be all right.
Nice to see things ain't changed. Over the years.
This is your first case, Phelps. It's okay to admit it if you're stumped. If you don't know what to do next, just come talk to me and we'll see what we can figure out.
Thanks, Stefan. You're okay.
All right. Let's go look at the crime scene. Let's talk to this guy.
I'm Officer Hart.
Phelps, traffic. What have you got?
Abandoned car, probably stolen. The solid citizen is Nate Wilkie. He called it in.
What gives with the coroner?
There's blood all over the interior. Someone's copped a full Broderick, but no stiff as yet.
We have an owner for the car?
The car is registered to an Adrian Black, just north of Bunker Hill.
All right, we'll take a look around.
I'll keep Mr. Wilkie talking, but don't make him wait too long. He's the restless type.
Detective Phelps, what have we got?
A lot of blood for a blunt force injury. The victim must be in a very bad way.
Any sign of the guy?
Not unless he's in the trunk of the car.
F. Morgan picked up a live pig yesterday.
Somebody bought a piggy.
Not sure this means much.
It's a tire iron. Sure nobody was beaten with it? No blood or anything on it? No
circumstantial.
Blood. All right. Okay. Yeah, that's nothing. Nothing.
Happier times, I guess.
Okay.
Years old, married. Sounds like an average guy. Yeah. What was he doing out here?
He might have been chasing a little strange, you never know. You know how those average married guys are.
Thank you.
Stenzel glasses. Home repaired by the look of it. Brand name might give us something to go on.
And sticky. Okay. That's a bloody pipe. That is a bloody pipe. Someone's been hit with that. Right, anything else? Is there nothing else I can look at?
Hey, Flatfoot. You're looking to get rid of that old crate? I'll give you a nickel for it.
Jeez. Wow.
Victim looks to have lost a lot of blood.
You think? Damn. That looks like two people were killed in their car. Man. To talk to the guy. I think we got all our evidence. Can we look at our notebook? Clues. Vehicle, blood splashes, hog, wallet, glasses, bloody pipe. Alright, we're good to go. Make sure there are no more markers. No more crime scene markers. Okay, now let's go talk to the dude. Make sure there isn't anything over here. Okay, let's go talk to Guy. Hello, hello? What's all this?
Sir, I'm Detective Phelps.
Name's Nate Wilkie.
You found the vehicle?
Sure. Saw it just sitting there. Strange place to be parking your car. Figured I'd better take a look. And then I saw all the blood. So I called the police.
Mind if I ask what you were doing out here?
Well, I work for the railway. I was on my way out to the switch and reckon I'd take a shortcut.
I'm gonna be nice to this guy.
Did you see anybody else in the yard? Maybe somebody hanging around the car?
Nope. I hadn't seen a soul all day till you boys turned up.
Do you know Adrian Black, Mr. Wilkie?
No, sir. That ain't a name I'm familiar with.
You ever seen the car before?
Funny enough, I did. A couple of nights ago, it was over there in the parking lot. I know most of the cars that park here regular, so it kind of stood out.
We found a steel pipe with blood on it near the car. You know anything about it, Mr. Wilkie?
No, sir. I went straight for the law when I saw the car was full of blood.
Thank you.
When you saw the blood, was it wet, bright red, or darker like it is now?
Darker, I'd say. Looked dry already.
The wallet by the car. Was there anything in it when you arrived?
You accusing me of something, mister?
No.
The wallet by the car. Was there anything in it when you arrived?
You accusing me of something, mister?
It's a simple question, Mr. Wilkie.
I wouldn't know what was in that wallet. I never touched it.
Thank you for your help, Mr. Wilkie.
We'll
contact your employer if we need anything more from you.
Oh, I missed a question.
If you have to, I guess. I can't really spend no more time over this.
Damn.
Somebody's got to inform the wife, Phelps. If you're done here, we'll head over there now. We're going to notify the wife. You seem to have it under control here.
Yeah, I got this.
Okay. We good to go now. I missed one question. Damn. Hold triangle next to a vehicle to make your partner drive.
From Washington.
...620 Bunker Hill Avenue. You know where that is?
Behind Bunker Hill. A couple blocks north of Central Station.
So, what do we tell the wife?
Play it by the book. There's no stiff yet, so let's see how it plays out. Could be a car theft gone wrong. Make Black drive somewhere lonely, then give him a tap.
But why leave the car?
Well, obviously, someone got a little heavy handed. It's the wrong way around. Well, how so, genius?
Where is Adrian? If you've gone to all the trouble to steal the car and it goes wrong, you leave the body behind, not the car.
Right.
You got something there, Phelps. It doesn't add up.
Read
about the guy on the crossing yesterday?
No, what happened?
Over on Lincoln Avenue. This guy's driving along and his oil light comes on. He stops the car and gets out. He pops the hood and...
He's on a rail crossing.
Oh, you got it. He's got his head under there checking the oil and the Southern Pacific freight slams into his car doing 90 miles an hour. The car came to a rest more than a mile down the track.
What a pointless waste of life.
You'll get plenty of blood and guts and mindless stupidity working traffic, Phelps. And who needs a Second Amendment when we'll give a goddamn fool the license to get behind the wheel of an automobile?
If it's a kidnapping, why leave the victim's ID? If it's a murder, why leave the car? The evidence doesn't add up.
Free lesson, Phelps. Evidence will only get you so far. You ask me, the whole thing feels hinky as hell.
What I wouldn't give to have your powers of intuition, Mikowski.
Don't worry, kid. Keep watching the master and you'll get there one day.
Around the corner. Oh, okay. Sorry. Get in the freaking car.
Wow.
There we go.
Let's go introduce ourselves. You talk to her, Phelps. I'm no good at this shoulder to cry on stuff.
Just a minute.
LAPD, Mrs. Black. May we come in? We have some bad news, and we'd rather discuss this in private.
I'm Margaret Black. We can discuss this in the living room. Please come in.
Your husband drives a blue Lincoln, Mrs. Black?
That's correct.
The car has been found abandoned, and I'm afraid there are signs of foul play.
I knew something was wrong when he didn't come home.
We believe your husband may be injured. We found a pipe on the scene with blood on it.
Oh, no! My poor Adrian!
Does the name InstaHeat mean anything to you, ma'am?
Yes, it does. We've just had a new water heater installed.
Whereabouts, Mrs. Black?
Just outside the kitchen window, at the side of the house.
I'd like you to try and stay calm and remember everything that you can about last night. My partner and I are going to take a look around. When you're ready, we're going to have some more questions for you. Is that okay?
Of course, officer. Anything to help secure my husband's safety.
Let's check the place out. Come on. Have a good look around. There's got to be something in here to go on.
Yeah. Look, dude. You do it. You do your thing in that room. I'll do my thing in this room. Tells me
lie down, make yourself
stores.
Comfortable.
Oh, it's that same doctor.
So, you're a friend of Courtney's?
It's that same doctor.
Yes, doctor. He seems very concerned about you. I have these visions. These blinding
really?
Visions. I can't get them out of my head. My skull, it feels like it's in a vice.
I'm going to give you something to calm your nerves. I want to take you on a journey back. I want you to remember the good things about your past, occasions that made you laugh, times that made you smile.
Yeah, okay. Okay, so newspapers are a collectible thing. I have a feeling there's a story, the story behind all that. Okay, why was she polishing silver? That's probably not important.
Kavanaugh's? So who brought this home? Maybe Adrian was a patron. R and I should have an address.
I'm looking at the detail on his hands. That's crazy.
Operator, message for KGPL.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
I need an address on a Kavanaugh's bar.
Certainly, Detective. One moment. Kavanaugh's bar, corner of Aliso and Hewitt, south side of Union Station.
Thank you.
Thank you.
This was only recently installed, not 2 days ago.
Maybe it's time we took a look around outside.
They cannot rust or corrode. They're guaranteed for 10 years. The water heater? Gas water heater. 8250. Wow. That was a lot of money for 1947. A lot of money. $850 down on easy terms. Yeah, $8250. My God, that was a lot of money. Okay, done that. Let's check the rest of the house. Oh, hello. Again with the Kavanaugh's matches. Oh, wait. Could there have been something written in them? That was there in case I didn't see the matches in the dining room.
This must be Adrian's. Stencil. So the glasses are a match. My Adrian. This thing gets more and more interesting.
I bet that's what it is. I bet he's faking his death. They put the pig in the car and beat up the pig so that the car was bloody, because they haven't found his body and they planted all his stuff, trying to make it look like he's dead. Taking a trip, are you?
A used ticket to Seattle and a suitcase gone missing. Someone couldn't wait to get out of this house.
Mm-hmm. Yep. He's trying to get away from something. I saw. Okay, it's just that. Yeah, I saw that already. Yep. Somebody's trying to split. What's that? Can I open that? No? Yep, he's trying to pull a fast one. I bet you that's what it is.
Separate bedrooms, separate pictures. What gives here?
Bedroom? Anything in her bedroom to find? No? No? Alright. Let's check out. Okay, that's the living room. We've been in there. This room and this room. We've been in there. Now the guy said to check. Oh, wait, what about the basement? Hold it. Hey! I didn't open that door.
Doesn't give me anything to go on.
Holy. Nope. Jeez, I didn't know Oxidol was that old.
Optimistic, Cole.
There's gotta be a reason the game let me open this door. Come in here. And it couldn't be to look at the... No. Wait, wait. Okay, no, that's the one for the stuff laying on the counter. Okay, I guess that's all. Why would the game let me come in here? And better yet, why would the game want me to waste an intuition point? Press L1 to use intuition to search for clues. I don't want to use my intuition points. How many points do I have? I only have one. Show all clues. Should I? Well, the game's telling me to do it. Okay. That's outside. I bet you that's the water heater outside. That's probably what that is. I shouldn't have wasted that point.
No use leaving the thing half finished.
And the pipes are missing. To select a piece. Oh, they want me to. Are you kidding me? Oh, wait.
No use leaving the thing half finished.
How do you place them?
No, that won't work.
No.
That looks wrong. So the pipe missing from Mr. Black's heater is the same one that killed him. Huh. Seems like the assailant is a little closer to home.
You think? But I still don't think he's dead. I think he's faking his death. Let's go talk to the little missus. Talk to the little woman, yeah? Oh, wait. What's that? Again with the matches. Okay, so they put plenty of matches all over the house so that if you didn't see them in one room, you'd see them in another. Okay. Go talk to the little woman. Hopefully, I can interrogate
I'm all right
her
now,
better.
Detectives.
Okay. Okay, what should I ask her first? She looks a little worried. Okay, hopefully I don't blow this.
Please hurry. My husband might be injured.
I think you should come clean with us, Mrs. Black.
Oh, shit,
your husband is missing, and after our search, I'm willing to call the circumstances suspicious. Can you account for your movements last night?
You're not accusing me, are you? What an awful thing to say. I was here all night, of course, waiting for Adrian to come home.
Oh, what is it, Caruso? No, your comments are still here. I see them. That you thought about, you were thinking about buying the game? Yeah. I see them. They're still here. I want to ask the right questions.
We found a receipt in the trunk of your husband's car for a live pig. This receipt was made out to an F. Morgan.
A pig? Adrian runs a tool business. That would be Frank Morgan. God knows what he's up to.
What makes you say that about Morgan, ma'am?
He's the foreman at my husband's plant. A very shady character. I've told Adrian he needs to keep his distance from the staff. They're always out drinking together.
Okay, drinking.
Your husband frequents Kavanaugh's bar?
How did you know that? Adrian practically lives there after work.
So Adrian spends a lot of time there.
Up until recently, he's been away in Seattle a lot on business.
That would explain a train ticket.
Did your husband tell you where he was going last night?
All he said was he was going to meet Frank for a drink.
I bet he skipped to Seattle.
So nothing out of the usual, then?
Well, he came home early from work. He never comes home early. And he went out early, too. He normally never leaves for the bar till about 7.
I think you should come clean with us, Mrs. Black. Your husband is missing, and after our search, I'm willing to call the circumstances suspicious. Can you account for your movements last night?
Should I already ask her this?
You're not accusing me, are you? Oh, what an awful thing to say. I was here all night, of course, waiting for Adrian to come home.
No. So nobody can account for your whereabouts. She's lying.
Yes, I am accusing you. Your husband was going to leave you. That's motive. Now your only alibi is an empty house. Get it off your chest. Tell me the truth.
Whatever your theories are, you're going to have to prove that I was there and that I wanted to hurt him. Do you think you can do that, detective? Find my husband,
Shit.
You incompetent fool, or the LAPD will be facing a lawsuit.
Shit.
Was your husband wearing his glasses when he left here yesterday?
Yes, he just bought a new pair.
Maybe he split town to be with his girlfriend.
Go on.
I kept telling him to throw those old ones away. He tried to repair them with tape. They looked terrible.
Tell us about the photo of Adrian in the bedroom.
What is there to tell? It's from his most recent business trip to Seattle.
She's lying. She's lying about that.
There's plenty to tell. You just won't tell it. You're lying about the photograph, Mrs. Black.
You're incredibly rude and insensitive. But I guess you know that. I've told you what I know about the picture.
What about Nicole, Mrs. Black? Was your husband going to leave you for her?
I've seen the photo frame. He thinks I'm stupid. But women sense these things.
I don't think he killed him, though.
If he intended to leave me, or if it was just a fling. God only knows. I only want to know that he's safe.
We'll keep you informed, Mrs. Black.
5 out of 6.
Please do, detective.
Oh, okay. Okay, I did pretty good then. Nice. I did pretty good. Excuse me, dude.
You can drive.
All right. Where to?
Jesus, I'm glad to be out of there.
Mr. and Mrs. Black don't seem to have the happiest home life.
He's too scared to divorce her, and she's too much of a shrinking violet to throw him out. If this hadn't happened, they could have stayed miserable together forever.
You think she could have killed him?
She sure as hell doesn't seem the type, but stranger things have happened.
Yes, Stranger Things. Such a good show. And if you haven't seen Stranger Things yet, go to Netflix and binge on it. It's a great show.
Hey, I know you.
No, you don't.
Can I talk to him?
What now?
Ask the barkeep. He'll know all the regulars.
Let's see if I can talk to this guy.
We were at school together. How about you buy me a drink?
I know that guy. What was it? He was the screw up on I want to say that 70s show. He was the one that worked in the hotel with Hyde. Yeah. Because he always come in, he always had an excuse. He was always late for work. See, that's what I love about this game. All the voice actors, you know, lend their faces to the game.
You looking for someone?
Awesome.
Boy, let's take it.
You know Frank Morgan?
Days.
Sure. Frank's your regular. He's a loner in the back.
He just refuses to accompany me to church.
Frank Morgan?
Who's asking?
I'm asking.
Three blondes walk into a bar. You'd think one of them would have seen it.
I'm pressing the button. Why isn't it working? Pressing the button. Oh, that's the wrong guy.
Cole Phelps, LAPD. I understand you're a friend of Adrian Black.
Yeah, I know him.
Are you aware that he's missing?
No, I hadn't heard that. Tough break.
Well, he doesn't seem too happy about it,
We found Black's car, abandoned in a freight depot, covered in blood. You know anything about that, Morgan?
Hell no. I'm sorry to hear that. I like Adrian. He's a good boss.
Please, don't tell me you actually believe this jerk-off, Phelps.
How many intuition points do I have? I still only have one. I don't want to use them yet. I want to see if I can... Well, since he's being the bad cop, I'll be a good cop here for a minute.
If Black is hurt, anything you give up might help us find him before it's too late.
Look, if something happened to Adrian, then I'm sorry to hear about that, but I don't know nothing more about it. I can't help you.
I love that look on his face, like derp, derp, derp.
When did you last see Adrian?
Hell, I don't know. I had plenty to drink last night. Things are a little sketchy.
If he was on his way to meet you when he went missing, you're gonna have to do a lot better than I don't recall.
He had a couple and then left, I guess. Maybe he had to go meet someone. That's the best I can do.
This doesn't add up, Morgan. Your excuses don't help.
I
Let's see how you enjoy
right.
the LAPD taking an interest in your life.
I missed
you want my
questions.
Opinion? We tell Morgan. I say he's lying, and whatever hole he's got Adrian stashed in, he's got to go back there sometime.
Right. Oh, I missed two questions. There he goes. I bet that's what it was. They got the cow, the pig, and they used the pig's blood.
He sure left his drink in a hurry.
And they made it look like...
I bet he wishes he'd rehearsed that story better now.
Thank you.
that's it. We're spotted. Back
Damn
off.
It.
Back we're off.
Not. We're not.
You want my opinion?
Okay.
We tell Morgan. I say he's lying, and whatever hole he's got Adrian stashed in, he's got to go back there sometime.
Okay. Let's see if we can do this.
Sure left his drink in a hurry.
Or tracking attention about driving recklessly, okay.
I bet he wishes he'd rehearsed that story better now.
You've got a pretty funny idea of what keeping a low profile means, Phelps.
Where are you taking us, Mr. Morgan?
Huh?
Now would be a bad time to forget.
Place out. Come on. Day one of the big time, and you're already tailing drunks home from bars. You having fun yet? I told you it was nonstop glamour working traffic, didn't I?
I'm just trying to learn.
Oh, come on, Phelps. Save the creepy teacher's pet stuff for Leary. Won't work on me.
Second apartment.
Apartment two.
Apartment two.
All right. Let's pay our friend a visit. See if he's missed us yet.
the hell is that?
Yep.
Will you relax? Jesus, Adrian, I told you, we're in the clear.
Alive.
I'll get it.
Hello.
Ah, shit. It's over, Morgan. Mr. Black, LAPD, give yourself up now.
No, he's not going to try to run.
Belts, go after him. I'll try and hit him off in the car. Remember, the gun is the last resort.
I didn't, where are you going? I'm going to lose him. Stop doing that.
There's no point running, Adrian.
Where is he? Where? Where is he? Oh.
Mr. Black, get back here right now.
Stop right there, Adrian.
How do you... can't jump. Where is... Oh, the drain pipe.
It's over, Adrian.
Oh, okay.
Why not just come clean with her, Black? Why the melodrama? I thought it would be easier. No, what? It just got a whole lot harder. Adrian Black, you're under arrest for conspiracy and
you
fraud.
Thought it would be
we'll see what the DA has to say about wasting police resources on a wild goose murder? Chase like this. You're gonna lose your wife, lose your job, and probably end up in the big house. I hope she was worth it, Adrian.
Dude, you'd rather make your wife think you've been slaughtered.
That turned out to be quite some case, huh?
Just man up,
Adrian.
And say, "Honey, I'm
what an idiot." You got an arrest and a clearance in your first case, and in fine style too. Well done, detective. Efficient investigation technique, good public presence. You keep that up, and you learn from Bukowski here. You can go a long way in this department.
Case closed. Yep. Clues found. 13 out of 14. Questions for an 8 out of 12. Ugh. Not too bad. Injury, city damage. Frank Morgan would have rolled over on Adrian Black with some tougher questioning. Ah. Well, I think that's, it's been about 3 hours. I think I'm going to leave it right here since we're at the end of a case. What do you think, gang? If you haven't seen this game before, what do you think? Aside from my ham-handed gameplay. I think it's good. I think it's really good. And I think I'm going to be playing this some more. I will probably... This is Wednesday... possibly Friday, this Friday at 6 p.m. Eastern. Hopefully I can be up at 6 p.m. I wanted to be up at 6 p.m. today, but I had some technical issues that I had to sort out. But they're all sorted, knock wood. But I will, yeah, I'm going to come back Friday at 6 p.m. Eastern with some more of L.A. Noire. Yeah, I think I'm going to do that. So if you want to know when I'm streaming again, follow me on Twitter. You can see my information right down there, my Twitter. Follow me on Twitter. Get with me on Discord because I send out the information when I'm going to be streaming and what I'm going to be streaming. what was I going to say? Like and subscribe on Facebook. Oh, Christ. It's not been my day. Like and subscribe on YouTube and hit me up on Twitter and Discord if you want to keep informed of when I'm going to be streaming again and what I'm going to be streaming. That's it for me for tonight. I think I need to... think I need to go have an energy drink, kind of wake me up, or some coffee, kind of pep me up a little bit, because I'm a little dizzy right now, but that's okay. So guys, if you want to, thanks for coming by. thanks for jumping into the stream with me. If you want to come back again, like I said, like and subscribe and hit me up on Twitter and on Discord. And with that said, good night, guys. And I will see you, hopefully see you, in the next stream. Good night.